Look at this.
They look real.
Actually, they're more real than I imagined. They're scary real.
They look legit. No!
Tucked away in the nooks and crannies of our world are villages that appear to defy the ordinary. These unique settlements, each with their own set of peculiarities and secrets, provide a glimpse into lifestyles and traditions that deviate from the norm of village life. From Cambodia's floating villages to Italy's cliffside residences, these locales defy traditional living with their unique settings and unconventional methods. Join us as we explore some of the world's most odd villages in the world. Scarecrow Village. One of the most striking examples of unusual communities is Nagaro, often referred to as Scarecrow Village, situated in Japan's Tokushima Prefecture. This village has transformed into a surreal landscape where the human population has been largely replaced by scarecrows. Once a lively community, Nagaro has experienced a significant decline in its residents over the years. The story begins with Ayano Tsukimi, a local woman who returned to Nagaro after living in Osaka. Upon her return, she found the village nearly deserted, with fewer than 50 residents remaining. To cope with the emptiness, Ayano crafted a scarecrow resembling her father, who had passed away. To her surprise, many neighbors mistook the scarecrow for her father and greeted it as such. This sparked an idea. As more townspeople left or died, she would replace them with scarecrows. Today, Nagaro is home to over 300 scarecrows that populate various locations throughout the village, including a closed school filled with scarecrow students. These figures can be seen fishing by the river or sitting at bus stops, creating an eerie yet fascinating atmosphere. Ayano's initiative has turned Nagaro into a living memorial, where each scarecrow tells a story of loss and nostalgia. The village's transformation reflects broader themes of abandonment and memory in rural Japan, where many communities face depopulation as younger generations migrate to urban areas in search of better opportunities. The village has become a tourist attraction, drawing visitors intrigued by its haunting charm and unique approach to preserving memories of the past. Visitors to Nagaro often find themselves captivated by the juxtaposition of life and artifice. The scarecrows not only serve practical purposes, such as deterring birds from gardens, but also provoke thought about community, identity, and the passage of time. In this way, Scarecrow Village stands as a testament to human creativity and resilience in the face of change. Before we delve into the fascinating and thought-provoking nature of this unique city, take a moment to absorb this image, an entire community where only women reside. It sounds like something straight out of a fantasy, yet it's a reality that sparks curiosity and raises countless questions. How did such a society come to be? Share your thoughts in the comments below. We're eager to hear your take on this mysterious and empowering phenomenon. Thames Town. A contemporary ghost town that mimics English architecture and culture, Thames Town is only 30 miles from Shanghai. This unique settlement features picturesque streets, charming pubs, and traditional phone booths, all reminiscent of an English village. However, despite its appealing appearance, Thames Town is largely empty, with high property prices deterring local residents from moving in. Originally envisioned as a thriving community for around 10,000 people, Thames Town was part of a larger development initiative aimed at attracting affluent residents and tourists. Construction was completed in 2006, and it was one of several Western-style towns built on the outskirts of Shanghai. The architectural design draws heavily from English influences, featuring elements such as a church, a fish and chip shop, and various other familiar structures. Despite its quaint charm and the initial excitement surrounding its development, Thames Town has struggled to attract permanent residents. The influx of wealthy investors drove property prices up significantly, making it unaffordable for the average person. As demand for housing surged, many potential residents found themselves priced out of the market. Consequently, the town has become a shell of its intended purpose, primarily serving as a backdrop for tourists seeking to explore its empty streets. Today, visitors to Thames Town can wander through its deserted avenues and admire the carefully crafted facades that mimic English life. While it may not be a bustling community as originally planned, Thamestown offers a unique glimpse into the intersection of cultural aspirations and economic realities. Its status as a ghost town highlights the complexities of urban development in modern China, where dreams of idyllic living can sometimes lead to unexpected outcomes. Fordlandia. In the 1920s, Henry Ford founded Fordlandia, an ambitious but ultimately unsuccessful attempt to build an industrial town in Brazil. The settlement was designed to support rubber production for Ford's automotive empire, addressing the company's growing need for this vital material. However, the project was marked by strict regulations that imposed significant restrictions on the inhabitants. Among these rules were bans on alcohol, tobacco, and even soccer, Brazil's most beloved pastime. The residents, who were primarily workers brought in to cultivate rubber, quickly grew dissatisfied with these oppressive conditions. The lack of freedom and the harsh lifestyle led to revolts, culminating in the eventual abandonment of the town. By 1930, the discontent among workers had reached a boiling point, and protests erupted against the stringent policies enforced by Ford's management. Today, Fordlandia stands as a ghost town, a haunting reminder of its past glory amidst a largely barren landscape. Once envisioned as a thriving community, it is now home to fewer than 3,000 people, with most of its infrastructure in ruins. The remnants of the town serve as a testament to Henry Ford's grand vision that ultimately fell short due to unrealistic expectations and a failure to understand the local culture and environment. Despite its troubled history, Fordlandia remains an intriguing site for visitors interested in industrial history and the complexities of cultural integration. The abandoned buildings and overgrown roads evoke a sense of nostalgia for what could have been, a prosperous community that served both its inhabitants and the needs of a growing automotive industry. As time passes, Fordlandia continues to fade into obscurity, yet it stands as a significant chapter in the story of American industrial ambition abroad. Coober Pedy. The majority of people in Coober Pedy, Australia, which is referred to as the opal capital of the world, live underground, providing a genuinely unique living experience. This mining town, which began as an opal mining hub, developed its subterranean lifestyle primarily due to the extreme temperatures experienced above ground. With summer temperatures often soaring above 40 degrees Celsius, 104 degrees Fahrenheit, living underground provides a comfortable climate year-round, making it an innovative adaptation to environmental challenges. The underground homes in Coober Pedy are not just functional, they are also creatively designed and equipped with modern amenities. Residents have transformed former mining shafts into cozy living spaces, shops, restaurants, and even churches. This unique architecture allows for a community that thrives beneath the surface, showcasing how people can adapt their lifestyles to harsh conditions. Growing up in Coober Pedy means embracing this unusual way of life. Children learn to navigate their underground homes and participate in activities that reflect their unique environment. The community has built a strong identity around its subterranean lifestyle, with many locals taking pride in their heritage as miners and residents of this distinctive town. In addition to its fascinating living conditions, Coober Pedy is renowned for its opal mining industry, attracting visitors from around the globe. Tourists come to explore the underground homes and learn about the town's history while searching for precious opals themselves. The combination of stunning natural landscapes and the quirky charm of underground living makes Coober Pedy a remarkable destination. All things considered, Coober Pedy is a fascinating location that never fails to captivate locals and tourists alike, because it is a prime example of how human ingenuity can transform environmental obstacles into chances for imaginative living. Popeye Village. The popular cartoon character Popeye the Sailor Man, who was portrayed by Robin Williams in the 1980 movie, is whimsically honored in Malta by Popeye Village. Constructed as a film set for the movie, this charming settlement was meticulously built beginning in 1979, featuring vibrant colors and detailed architecture that evoke the fictional world of Sweet Haven. After filming concluded, rather than dismantling the elaborate set, the creators decided to preserve it and transform it into a tourist destination. This decision allowed visitors to step into the enchanting realm of Popeye and his friends, experiencing the magic of the film firsthand. Despite receiving mixed reviews upon its release, Popeye Village has become a cherished attraction for fans and tourists alike. Visitors can wander through the village's quaint streets, explore its colorful buildings, and enjoy various activities that celebrate the spirit of the film. The site features numerous photo opportunities, allowing guests to capture memories in this picturesque setting. The charm of Popeye Village lies not only in its connection to a classic character, but also in its ability to transport people into a nostalgic world filled with joy and whimsy. Over the years, Popeye Village has evolved into more than just a film set. It has become a vibrant community that hosts events and activities throughout the year. Families and fans flock to this unique destination, drawn by its playful atmosphere and rich history. Zappi. In the southeastern region of Poland lies Zappi, a city renowned for its vibrant artistic expression that permeates every corner. This community has transformed itself into an open-air gallery, where homes and public spaces are adorned with colorful paintings, creating a visual feast for residents and visitors alike. The tradition of decorating the village began in the 1800s, when local residents sought to brighten their soot-stained walls, which had darkened over time due to coal burning and other industrial activities. As a response to the dreary environment, mothers began painting cheerful designs on their homes, turning the necessity of maintaining their living spaces into an artistic endeavor. This practice quickly spread throughout the community, evolving into a citywide celebration of creativity. The transformation of Zappi into a canvas for artistic expression reflects the resilience and ingenuity of its residents. The artistic flair of Zappi is not limited to just homes. It extends to barns, fences, and even furniture, showcasing the residents' commitment to beautifying their surroundings. The colorful murals reflect a wide range of themes, from traditional folklore to modern abstract art, making every street a canvas filled with life and expression. This dedication to creativity has turned Zappi into a vibrant tapestry of color that tells stories about its culture and history. Zappi's vibrant atmosphere has made it a popular destination for artists and photographers seeking inspiration. The city's commitment to art has fostered a sense of community pride as residents take part in maintaining and enhancing their colorful environment. Local festivals often celebrate artistic achievements, allowing residents to showcase their talents while reinforcing community bonds. Zappi is a prime example of how art has the power to improve a community and its residents' quality of life. It is evidence of the ability of creativity to overcome hardship and improve day-to-day living. The village's artistic legacy has become an integral part of its identity, fostering connections among residents while attracting those eager to experience its unique culture. Zappi stands as an inspiring example of how communities can embrace creativity to redefine their environments. As visitors stroll through its colorful streets, they witness firsthand how art can breathe life into a place, turning it into a vibrant hub of expression and connection. For anyone exploring Poland's cultural landscape, Zappi is undoubtedly a must-visit destination that highlights the beauty found in creativity and community spirit. Mausoleum. The official record for the wettest place on Earth is Mausoleum in India. This small town receives nearly 700 inches of rain annually, leading to an extraordinary climate characterized by torrential downpours that can last for weeks. The extreme weather conditions have significantly influenced the lifestyle and architecture of Mausoleum, prompting residents to develop unique adaptations to cope with the relentless rainfall. The monsoon season in Mausoleum typically begins in May and extends through October, bringing heavy rains that can result in continuous precipitation for days on end. This remarkable amount of rainfall is attributed to the region's geographical location, which traps moisture-laden winds from the Bay of Bengal. As a result, Mausoleum experiences some of the most intense rainfalls recorded globally, creating a lush, green landscape, but also presenting challenges for its inhabitants. To mitigate the impact of such extreme weather, many homes in Mausoleum are equipped with grass-covered roofs. These roofs serve multiple purposes. They help absorb sound, reducing the noise from heavy rain, and provide insulation against the cold. Additionally, the natural materials used in construction help prevent water damage, allowing homes to withstand the constant onslaught of rain. Mawson Ram is home to a resilient community that has adapted to its environment despite its difficult climate. The locals have developed a strong connection to their land and often engage in agriculture, cultivating crops that thrive in the wet conditions. The vibrant greenery and cascading waterfalls surrounding the town create a picturesque setting that attracts visitors seeking to experience this unique environment. The ability of human ingenuity to adapt to harsh weather conditions is best demonstrated by Mawson Ram. Its status as the wettest place on Earth not only shapes the daily lives of its residents, but also contributes to a rich cultural identity rooted in resilience and harmony with nature. Tristan da Cunha. Tristan da Cunha, the most isolated inhabited island in the world, is a volcanic archipelago in the South Atlantic Ocean. This isolated island is home to approximately 250 inhabitants who reside in a small settlement known as Edinburgh of the Seven Seas. Life on Tristan da Cunha is characterized by its peaceful yet isolated nature, as the island's remoteness presents unique challenges for its residents. The nearest landmass, St. Helena, is a staggering 2,437 kilometers away, making access to Tristan da Cunha quite difficult. The only practical means of transportation to the island is by boat, with journeys taking around 6 days from the nearest major city, Cape Town, in South Africa. This level of isolation has fostered a close-knit community where residents have grown accustomed to their secluded lifestyle. Life is peaceful and frequently picturesque on Tristan da Cunha, despite its difficulties. The inhabitants enjoy stunning natural beauty, with dramatic landscapes featuring rugged cliffs and volcanic terrain. The community engages in fishing and farming, relying on the island's resources for sustenance. However, they must also contend with the potential threat posed by the active volcano at the center of the archipelago, which serves as a constant reminder of nature's power. The residents of Tristan da Cunha have developed a unique culture shaped by their isolation. They celebrate traditional customs and maintain strong familial ties, fostering a sense of belonging in their remote home. While some may view life on this distant island as challenging, many inhabitants find comfort and contentment in their peaceful surroundings. One of the most remarkable examples of human adaptability and resilience in one of the world's most remote locations is Tristan da Cunha. It showcases how communities can thrive despite geographical challenges, creating a rich tapestry of life amidst stunning natural beauty. The island's unique circumstances foster a deep connection among its inhabitants, who have learned to embrace their isolation while celebrating their shared heritage and way of life. As they navigate the complexities of living in such a remote location, the people of Tristan da Cunha continue to exemplify the spirit of community and perseverance against all odds. Gimmelwald. Gimmelwald, a charming village renowned for its serene surroundings and breathtaking natural beauty, is tucked away in Switzerland's stunning Bern Canton. This idyllic, car-free community offers a unique living experience where residents and visitors alike can immerse themselves in the tranquility of the surrounding Alps. The absence of cars ensures that the landscape remains unspoiled, allowing everyone to fully appreciate the breathtaking views and fresh mountain air. Gimmelwald relies primarily on bicycles for transportation, creating a peaceful atmosphere free from the noise and pollution typically associated with vehicular traffic. Access to this charming village is primarily via a steep cable car that connects it to neighboring towns, providing an exhilarating ride that showcases the stunning scenery. This commitment to maintaining a vehicle-free environment not only enhances the quality of life for residents, but also preserves the natural beauty that attracts visitors from around the world. The picturesque setting of Gimmelwald is characterized by lush green meadows, towering mountains, and charming wooden chalets that dot the landscape. The village exemplifies how preserving nature can enhance quality of life, offering residents spectacular views and a peaceful atmosphere. The architecture reflects traditional Swiss design, with wooden buildings that harmoniously blend into their natural surroundings. This thoughtful integration of human habitation and nature creates a visually stunning environment that captivates all who visit. Residents of Gimmelwald engage in various outdoor activities such as hiking, skiing, and mountain biking, making the most of their pristine environment. The emphasis on outdoor living fosters a strong sense of community among inhabitants, who often gather for seasonal festivals and events that celebrate their connection to nature. These gatherings not only strengthen community bonds, but also provide opportunities for residents to share their love for the outdoors with visitors. The opportunity to experience a slower pace of life away from busy cities is another reason why visitors are drawn to Gimmelwald in addition to its natural beauty. The village serves as a perfect retreat for those seeking relaxation and adventure in equal measure. Whether exploring scenic trails or simply enjoying the breathtaking views from their doorsteps, both residents and tourists find solace in Gimmelwald's serene ambiance. Sunland Holiday Village. South Australia's Sunland Holiday Village is famous for being the nation's only nudist village, a fact that its residents are very proud of. Established in the 1970s by a dedicated group of nudists, this community spans approximately 10 hectares and continues to thrive as a haven for those who embrace a clothing-free lifestyle. The village fosters an environment where individuals can express themselves freely, promoting body positivity and acceptance. The current manager emphasizes that Sunland has cultivated a community of like-minded individuals who respect one another and the natural surroundings. The guiding principles of this unique village are straightforward: respect for each other and for nature. This ethos has allowed Sunland to maintain a peaceful atmosphere, creating a welcoming space for both residents and visitors. To ensure that everyone feels comfortable, Sunland enforces strict policies against any form of inappropriate behavior. This commitment to maintaining a respectful environment is crucial for the village's harmonious coexistence. Newcomers are encouraged to take their time adjusting to the lifestyle, with no pressure to conform if they find it unsuitable. This approach helps ease individuals into the community, allowing them to explore nudism at their own pace. Residents of Sunland appreciate the freedom that comes with living without clothes, often citing it as a liberating experience that enhances their connection to nature. The village hosts various events and activities that promote social interaction and community bonding, further enriching the experience of living in this unique environment. Sunland Holiday Village stands out not only for its status as Australia's only nudist village, but also for its commitment to fostering a respectful and inclusive community. It serves as an example of how adopting a non-traditional way of life can result in individual liberty and a strong sense of community among its inhabitants. Yanggi. In the southwestern region of China's Sichuan province lies Yanggi, a city notable for its unusually high population of dwarfs, with approximately 40% of its residents falling under this category. This phenomenon has intrigued scientists and researchers who seek to understand the underlying causes of such a significant prevalence of dwarfism in one community. Locals attribute this unique demographic trend to historical factors, particularly viral outbreaks that may have affected growth during childhood. These outbreaks are believed to have impacted the health of many individuals in the area, leading to stunted growth. Despite the challenges associated with their stature, many residents of Yanggi have adapted to their circumstances and found ways to thrive within their community. The city has developed a vibrant culture that embraces its identity, with many inhabitants engaging in work within the entertainment sector. Amusement parks and circuses often employ local residents, providing them with opportunities to showcase their talents and earn a living. While some may view these jobs as limiting, many in Yanggi find joy and fulfillment in their roles, contributing positively to the local economy. Yanggi's distinct demographic composition has drawn attention from various scientific circles, prompting studies aimed at uncovering the reasons behind the high concentration of dwarves. Researchers have conducted genetic testing, analyzed dietary habits, and examined environmental factors, yet no definitive conclusions have been reached. The quest for answers continues as experts strive to unravel this intriguing mystery. Despite its challenges, Yanggi stands as a testament to resilience and adaptation. The community fosters a sense of belonging among its residents, who support one another and celebrate their shared experiences. As the city navigates its unique identity amidst ongoing scientific inquiry, Yanggi remains a fascinating example of how diverse human experiences can shape a community's character and culture. Jamal. Transitioning from a serene nudist community, we arrive at Jamal, a city marked by a darker history. Between 1939 and 1945, during World War II, Jamal became known as a breeding ground for white supremacists and extremist ideologies. This troubling legacy has shaped the city's identity, creating an atmosphere that raises concerns among visitors and residents alike. Despite its small size, Jamal has garnered attention for its unsettling environment, where Nazi imagery is reportedly prevalent. Inhabitants are said to greet each other with Nazi salutes, reflecting a community that has embraced these extremist beliefs. This alarming trend has made Jamal a controversial location, drawing scrutiny from outside observers and highlighting ongoing tensions surrounding its historical legacy. The presence of such ideologies in Jamal raises questions about the social dynamics within the community. While some residents may feel a sense of belonging within this extremist framework, others may find themselves at odds with the prevailing attitudes. The city's reputation as a haven for white supremacists complicates its identity as it struggles to reconcile its past with the realities of modern society. In recent years, efforts have been made to address the troubling aspects of Jamal's history. Activists and community leaders have sought to promote tolerance and understanding, aiming to counteract the negative influences that have taken root in the city. However, these initiatives face significant challenges in a community where extremist views have become entrenched, a clear reminder of how historical occurrences can influence regional cultures and identities is provided by Jamal's legacy. Despite its struggles with the past, the city continues to serve as a hub for conversations about social cohesiveness and extremism in modern society. Igbo Aura. In Nigeria lies Igbo Aura, often referred to as the twin capital of the world. This village is remarkable for its extraordinarily high rate of twin births, boasting a twinning rate of 158 per 1,000 live births, far exceeding global averages, where twins account for only about 3% of births. The phenomenon has attracted significant attention from researchers and scientists who seek to understand the underlying causes of this unique demographic trend. Locals attribute the high incidence of twin births to a special leaf commonly used in their cuisine. This ingredient, known locally as oha or ugu, is believed to enhance fertility and increase the likelihood of having twins. Families in Igbo Aura often incorporate this leaf into their traditional dishes, which they believe contributes to the village's remarkable twinning rate. This cultural belief intertwines with biological phenomena, illustrating how local practices can shape demographic patterns. The residents of Igbo Aura take great pride in their reputation as the twin capital. The community celebrates this uniqueness through various festivals and events that honor twins, fostering a sense of identity and belonging among its inhabitants. These celebrations often include traditional dances, music, and communal feasting, drawing visitors from surrounding areas who come to witness the festivities. Moreover, the high rate of twinning has implications for local healthcare and social structures. Families with twins often receive special attention and support from the community, as raising multiple children simultaneously can be challenging. This communal approach helps ensure that all children, especially twins, receive care and resources. Despite its challenges, Igbo Aura thrives as a vibrant community, where cultural beliefs and practices play a significant role in shaping daily life. The village's identity as the twin capital not only attracts tourists, but also fosters a strong sense of pride among residents. As researchers continue to explore the reasons behind this extraordinary phenomenon, Igbo Aura remains a fascinating example of how culture and biology intersect in shaping human experiences. Auroville. Auroville was founded in 1968 as an experimental township in India. It covers approximately 20 square kilometers. As of 2018, the population of Auroville had nearly 3,000 residents. Founded on the principles of universal fellowship, Auroville aims to create an egalitarian society where individuals are treated equally, regardless of their background. The township is a unique social experiment that seeks to transcend traditional societal norms and foster a sense of community among its diverse inhabitants. One of the most remarkable aspects of Auroville is its crime-free environment. Residents earn similar salaries irrespective of their professions, promoting a sense of equality and shared purpose. This model challenges conventional economic structures and encourages collaboration over competition. Oroville operates without traditional politics or racism, attracting individuals from around the globe who are drawn to its vision of a harmonious society. At the heart of Oroville lies the Matra Mandir, a meditation center designed to promote silence and introspection. This iconic structure serves as a spiritual focal point for residents and visitors alike, embodying the township's commitment to inner peace and self-discovery. The Matra Mandir is surrounded by lush gardens, offering a serene environment for reflection and meditation. While many view Oroville as a progressive model for future living, others criticize it as a potential dystopian experiment. Detractors argue that its utopian ideals may overlook practical realities and individual freedoms. Nonetheless, Oroville continues to thrive as a unique community that challenges societal norms and promotes inclusivity. The human desire for a better world is exemplified by Oroville. Its commitment to equality, sustainability, and spiritual growth offers valuable insights into alternative ways of living. Oroville continues to be a fascinating illustration of how societies can work toward harmony in the face of diversity as it negotiates the complexities of contemporary life. Colma. Colma, California is commonly referred to as the City of Souls or the City of the Dead. This small town, located just outside San Francisco, is unique in that approximately 75% of its land is occupied by cemeteries. While Colma has around 1,500 living residents, it is home to over 1.5 million deceased individuals. The town's eerie reputation stems from historical events in San Francisco during the early 1900s, when space for burials ran out. As San Francisco grew in population and urban development increased, the city faced a significant challenge, a shortage of burial space. By 1912, authorities decided to ban new internments within city limits, prompting them to relocate existing cemeteries to Colma. Between 1920 and 1941, an estimated 150,000 bodies were exhumed from their original resting places and moved to Colma, transforming the town into a significant burial site. Colma is now a unique destination for people drawn to its eerie charm, in addition to being a place of rest for the dead. The presence of numerous cemeteries has shaped the town's character, with well-maintained grave sites and memorials that reflect the rich history of those interred there. Visitors can explore various cemeteries, each with its own distinct features and notable figures, including famous personalities from California's past. Despite its morbid reputation, Colma is more than just a city of graves. It is also home to a small but vibrant community. The living residents have created a peaceful atmosphere amidst the surrounding cemeteries, often engaging in community events and maintaining a strong sense of identity. The juxtaposition of life and death in Colma invites reflection on mortality while celebrating the lives that have come before. As we conclude our exploration of the most unusual villages in the world, we're left with a sense of awe and wonder at the extraordinary resilience and ingenuity of human beings. From remote, almost mythical communities to places where the very fabric of everyday life seems to defy reason, these villages exist as living testaments to the strange and the exceptional. What untold stories and ancient mysteries still echo through these far-flung corners of the earth? If these incredible villages captivated your imagination as they did ours, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share your thoughts. The world is full of wonders. Let's keep discovering them together.